To begin Leon Draisaitl's career simulation at 25 years old, him and McDavid are looking to make Edmonton the city of champions once again. Draisaitl is having a fantastic year to start out the sim, recording 51 goals and 43 assists for 94 points. The Oilers are doing amazing as well, finishing with a league best 55-22-5 record. However, the Oilers would run into the red-hot Golden Knights and they're falling in 6 games in the second round. Draisaitl was terrific in the postseason, recording 4 goals and 12 assists in 13 games. Headed into next season, the Oilers are looking to learn from their mistakes and make another run at the Stanley Cup. Also, if you haven't already, make sure to subscribe. I'm trying to hit 2,000 subs by the end of the year, and every single sub is greatly appreciated. McDavid and Draisaitl were unstoppable this season, with McDavid scoring 114 points and Draisaitl recording 105. With a 94-25-8 record, we have ourselves a Battle of Alberta in the first round, with the Edmonton Oilers taking on the Calgary Flames. But who cares about the Battle of Alberta, because here we are, the Stanley Cup Final taking on the Tampa Bay Lightning. It's time for Draisaitl and McDavid to get their first cup together. And when the series came to a close, the Edmonton Oilers are Stanley Cup champions once again, with Leon Draisaitl leading the way, taking home Conn Smythe. Leon would record over a point a game, scoring 30 in 25 games. After winning a Stanley Cup, the Oilers made a questionable decision, splitting up Connor McDavid and Leon Draisaitl. And what's even more questionable is putting McDavid on the second line. I have a feeling this is going to backfire on us real fast. Draisaitl would see a massive dip in production, going from 105 points the year prior to only 75. Luckily, that dip in production wasn't linked to the team's success, as they would finish with a 45-30-7 record. But maybe his production was linked to the Oilers' success, as they would be swept in 4 games. Not only was this a terrible postseason for the Oilers, but Draisaitl was abysmal, recording only 1 point in 4 games. Coming into this season, small changes were made, resulting in McDavid and Draisaitl switching spots in the lineup. Draisaitl would have another similar season, potting 35 goals while picking up 42 helpers. With a disappointing 40-37-5 record, the Oilers are going to be missing the playoffs. Maybe this is a sign to put them back on the same line together. It looks like the Oilers still haven't figured out what's wrong, and they're keeping Draisaitl and McDavid on separate lines. The only reason that I'm not switching the lines myself is I want to have zero impact on the sim. Draisaitl would once again have a slow year, recording only 74 points in 82 games. But with a record of 40-36-6, the Oilers somehow got themselves back into a playoff position. Now we just need to perform. Well, they performed. They just didn't perform well. Swept in 4 to Dallas. Draisaitl was non-existent in the playoffs, recording only 1 goal. If this team wants success, we need more from you, my guy. We also need more from McDavid. I'm not going to ignore your 2 points. It seems as though the Oilers did find a bit of success with Connor and Leon on separate lines. Then again, who cares if you make the playoffs if you get swept in the first round? Draisaitl would have the slowest season of his career, finishing well under a point a game with 65 points in 82 games. But his poor season wouldn't hurt the team too much. They would finish with a 44-33-5 record, and we have ourselves the Battle of Alberta once again. Edmonton would have zero problems with Calgary, sweeping them in 4 games, but would have no answer for Vegas in the second round. Leon Draisaitl would perform better in the postseason, recording 4 goals and 5 assists for 9 points in 11 games. The Oilers have finally come to their senses and reunited the dynamic duo of McDavid and Draisaitl. Now that this duo is back together, expect big things this season. Leon had a slightly better season, recording 30 goals and 40 assists for 70 points. With a 47-27-8 record, Edmonton's making the playoffs once again, where they're matched up with the team that eliminated them last season, the Las Vegas Golden Knights. Edmonton would get their revenge on Vegas, but would be swept in 4 games to the eventual Stanley Cup champions, the Anaheim Ducks. Draisaitl would be subpar in the postseason, only recording 6 points in 10 games. Now that the dynamic duo of McDavid and Draisaitl have 1 season under their belt as line mates, I expect big things with their renewed chemistry. Draisaitl bounced back in a huge way, scoring over a point a game with 87 points in 82 games, while McDavid, he had 101 points. That renewed chemistry is going to have an impact on the Oilers' record. They finished with a record of 45-25-12. In a tough 7-game series versus Dallas, Edmonton would be able to sneak past them, but would once again be stopped by the Golden Knights in the second round. Draisaitl once again underperformed in the postseason, scoring only 6 points in 12 games. After another loss to Vegas in the playoffs, changes were made to stack the Oilers' first line. Draisaitl would have another great season, scoring 37 goals and picking up 53 assists, but his stats mean nothing if he doesn't perform in the postseason. Edmonton finished with a record of 44-30-8, and they're focused on getting revenge against Vegas in the second round. They're not even thinking about the Kings. And for what it feels like the 1,000th time in this sim, the Oilers are falling to the Golden Knights. The only difference this time is Vegas went on to become Stanley Cup champs. Draisaitl was better in the postseason, finishing with 7 points in 9 games. It doesn't matter how many games we win, It doesn't matter how many points McDavid and Draisaitl get. We need to beat Vegas. Leon Draisaitl would have another solid year, finishing with 33 goals and 54 helpers. With a league best 55-23-4 record, there's no more excuses. We have to beat Vegas. At least we didn't lose to Vegas. Nah, but seriously, that's tough. That's real tough. So I think I know where we went wrong. Draisaitl was fantastic, 14 points. McDavid recorded 12, and Wahlstrom, he had 11. But the drop-off after those three guys is pretty crazy. The biggest problem with this team right now is a lack of depth, and it doesn't seem like that was addressed, so I expect a similar season. Draisaitl would have a terrific year, finishing with 33 goals and 63 assists from 96 points. The Oilers have a record of 49-25-8, but who really cares? I'm setting two goals for the playoffs. Number one, don't lose in the first round. Number two, don't lose to Vegas. It's that simple. This is actually stupid. If we ever play Vegas in the first round, we shouldn't even show up. I hate it here. Draisaitl was great, but who cares? We can't beat Vegas. Alright, I'm sick and tired of losing to Vegas. Do whatever you have to in order to not play them. Maybe we have to relocate to the Eastern Conference. Then again, if we do that, then we'll just meet them in the Stanley Cup Final and lose. For the first time in I don't know how many years, Leon Draisaitl is leading the team in scoring with 83 points in 82 games. Well, I'm ready to lose to Vegas in the second round. Not only did we lose in the first round, but so did Vegas. If we were ever to win it, it was this season. I don't even care what Draisaitl's numbers were. All I feel is pain. With Draisaitl's contract coming to an end, I want him to leave Edmonton with the sole reason of avoiding to play Vegas in the playoffs. Draisaitl performed terrific in his contract year with a team-high 97 points. Alright, do not screw this up. Not only do we have a league-best 58-20-4 record, but Vegas missed the playoffs. This is our year. Let's go get Draisaitl another cup. Here we are, the Stanley Cup Final. The Edmonton Oilers are taking on the Pittsburgh Penguins with the hopes of winning another Stanley Cup. This is our year. We're gonna do whatever it takes to win. I can't express pain in words. I don't even know what to say. Draisaitl, you were unbelievable. 35 points in 24 games? I'm sorry we couldn't win it for you. In free agency, Leon Draisaitl was tired of the constant disappointment and he decided he was gonna take his talents to the Toronto Maple Leafs. I don't think anyone expected that one. Draisaitl would have another fantastic year, recording 96 points in 82 games, while the Leafs, they would finish with a 46-27-9 record, and we're taking on the Sabres in the first round. Also, Edmonton's taking on Vegas in the first round. Toronto wouldn't do much better than Edmonton, as both teams would lose in Game 7 of the first round. Draisaitl would do pretty good in the postseason, recording 6 points in 7 games. With age catching up to Draisaitl at 39 years old, this is expected to be his final year. Let's go get this man one last cup. Also, if you can't beat him, join him. So Toronto lost to the Sabres, and he joined the Sabres. Age doesn't affect this man because at 40 years old, he's finishing second on the team and scoring with 77 points. With a record of 46-34-2, Draisaitl is going to be on the opposite side of the series compared to last season as the Sabres are taking on the Leafs. But this time, with Draisaitl on the team, the Sabres are going to fall in 5 games. Keep in mind, Toronto just made it to the Cup Final without him, and Edmonton made it to the Conference Finals and lost to the Stanley Cup champs. I guess Draisaitl refused to retire because at 42 years old, he's still playing, and I can't be bothered to simulate any further, so that's where I'm ending today's career simulation. If you enjoyed this video, I definitely recommend checking the one on screen, and if you haven't already, make sure to drop a like and subscribe.